structure is partly something your soil is born with. Soil texture, or the mix of sand, silt, and clay on your land, will change only on geologic timescales, and different soil textures have different potential for structure. But farming practices can substantially change soil structure. Soil structure has to do with the spaces between particles, where air and water move around the soil. Soil aggregates are critical for holding water in the soil for two reasons. First, a well-aggregated soil has large pores between aggregates to let water enter the soil profile. Second, small pores within aggregates hold water tightly enough to keep it around, but loosely enough for plant roots to access it. It's critical that soil both let water flow in and hold water for later. If your soil doesn't let water infiltrate, you'll have ponding, runoff, soil loss, and lower plant water supply. If your soil doesn't hold water, plants suffer from drought. Here, you can see a stark difference in structure between this unfarmed edge of field area and the headlands of the adjacent pea field. Under unfarmed grass, we have this loose mixture of larger and smaller aggregates. Remember, we want large pores for infiltration and small pores for water holding capacity, so a variety of aggregates is good. On the headlands, there's clearly some compaction. When I jab a knife in, I hit a dense layer around 6 to 8 inches. When I take the soil in my hands, it comes out in large clumps, which are difficult to break apart. The crop has really suffered here, as field peas are especially sensitive to soil structure. Peas partner with rhizobium for their nitrogen supply, which need oxygen. Compacted soil will have less oxygen because it has less connected, smaller pores. Roots also have a hard time getting through compacted soil. And on this compacted headland, there aren't a lot of roots below 15 inches. Here in the middle of the pea field, the healthy plants above ground are an indication that things are better below ground, and that's what we see in the pit. There's much better structure, which lets both roots and earthworms get access to the water and air they need. Pea roots are much more abundant below 15 inches in this non-compacted area. Making space for roots also allows roots to help you. You can see what roots can do even more clearly in the unfarmed grass area. Roots are really wonderful for holding soil aggregates together. Aggregates near roots are actually stronger than aggregates in the bulk soil. Roots physically bind soil particles like strings around a package, and they also attract microbes. Microbes live on the surfaces of roots, and as they eat and grow and die, their bodies leave a sticky film of organic matter behind. That organic matter holds aggregates together too. These roots are one of the big benefits of planting a cover crop. This is from a no-till cover crop field nearby, and you can see that over a month after terminating the cereal rye cover crop, these roots are still actively holding soil structure together. Minimizing and controlling traffic is a great way to build soil structure. The headlands are bound to see heavy use, but platy structure like this can develop under any wheel track. Tillage also destroys soil's natural structure, replacing it with an artificial fluff that will collapse into compaction if you don't till again. Aggregates in regularly tilled soil have been found to have about 80% of the pores in no-till aggregates, so even the aggregates that you do have in a tilled situation can't hold water. Reducing tillage allows the natural structure to do its job. Planting a cover crop gives you more roots in the ground over the course of the year. Some of the best windows to establish a cover crop are after a canning crop like peas, small grains, or corn silage, so the cover crop has more time to grow before the winter freeze. For a corn-soybean rotation, we have two Minnesota-specific cover crop recipes detailing low-risk options. We recommend cereal rye after corn and oats after soybean. More information on implementing cover crops and protecting soil structure can be found online.
Sign up for Minnesota Crop News email alerts on the latest in research updates and current growing conditions.